Yes, my dear students, welcome back. I hope that all of you are healthy and fine and happy. Today, you are going to learn the poem On Children. What is the name of the poem? On Children, written by this Khalil Gibran. Khalil Gibran is the poet of the poem On Children. This is chapter number 3. Who is this Khalil Gibran? Khalil Gibran is the poet of this poem. He was born in Lebanon, but he took American citizenship. It is why he is called a Lebanese American artist and poet. And this poem is selected from the work. Work means one book. The name of the book is The Prophet. The Prophet means Christian father, Christian philosopher who gives the speech on devotion philosophy. He is called The Prophet. In this book, there are 26 speeches on God, different varieties. This On Children is a part of the book The Prophet, which contains 26 sermons. Sermons means speeches on philosophy. What are the topics discussed in this The Prophet means regarding the love, marriage, children, houses, class, etc. There are 26 topics in the book The Prophet, written by this Lebanese American poet Khalil Gibran. Next, then, what is the background to this poem means? This father, prophet's name is Al-Mustafa. This Al-Mustafa in the story belonged to London. And he was touring across the world, going to East African countries. What is the name of the country? Means it is in the city Arpalis. It is the name of a nation or country, and he stayed there for 12 years. After giving speeches on God to the local citizens of Arpalis, and he stayed there for 12 years. After 12 years were over, he wanted to go back to his motherland, this was England. When he was about to enter or board the ship, another lady, one lady, her name is Al-Mitra. Al-Mitra is a nun, unmarried Christian lady. And Al-Mustafa is a father or prophet. He is also unmarried. Then Al-Mitra requested Al-Mustafa to say some speech to the local people. He gave speeches regarding these all matters. When he was about to enter the ship, then what happened? One woman who was holding a small baby against her bosom. Bosom means chest. One young lady was holding a small baby against her chest, and she requested this father, Al-Mustafa, "Oh father, oh prophet, oh please say some words on children. Say some words on children, not about her particular child. Please understand the difference." My dear students, I would like to tell you one important message, and you treat this one as the important instruction suggestion. You should have understood these three chapters in this method, in this manner. Then only you can understand the remaining 4 to 14 chapters. Otherwise, you never can understand the remaining 11 chapters. My dear students, don't be careless. If you are not understood anyone, repeat this one. You play this video often and often, you must come to this level. We cannot go more down. It is why, my dear students, please follow my words. You must understand Romeo and Juliet poem, two-dear poem on children. If you are careless, you never can understand the forthcoming 11 chapters. Please care for my words. English marks will care for you. Otherwise, nobody can help you. Please, don't be careless. Please listen. Now, this lady is holding a baby and she requests the Al-Mustafa father, prophet, to say something on our children. Here is one thought. Al-Mustafa is unmarried. How can he say something on children? It is the power of the prophet or father or philosopher. It is why nothing is impossible for the seer. Seer means monks, rishi, muni. This is why he gives speech on children. He says about all children universally, not about one particular child. This is the difference between mass children and particular children. He gives this sermon or speech regarding all children in the world, not about one particular child. This is the fact and truth what you should understand. Next one. There are two words repeated in this poem. One is you. You means who? Not children or students. You means parents. Then they is there. They means what? They means who? Children. All children. You means parents. And they means you means parents. They means children. This one. Next one. This poem contains 14 lines. How many lines? 14 lines. These first 5 lines say who are children? What are children? This poem is divided into 2 parts. While I was explaining the poem Romeo and Juliet, I gave you one secret that poem must be divided into 2 parts. I announced this one in the first poem. That is useful to this poem. It is why, my dear students, follow the teaching strictly. Strictly, mass will follow you. This is the condition, law of English. That's all. Okay, remaining 9 lines belong to how parents should take care of their children. What is the role played by the parents in bringing up their children? This is explained. Once more, there are 14 lines in this poem. First 5 lines belong to the children. Who are children? What are children? This is explained. Remaining 9 lines explain what are the responsibilities of the parents to grow up their children. This is explained. This is the background or context to the poem. Now, introduction, 2 lines. What is the introduction? On Children is a philosophical and thought-provoking poem. See? Philosophical means what? It inspires some philosophical thoughts, means some devotion will move towards God. God is supreme. It is explained in this poem. God is the supreme. He can make the parents to take care of the children. This is the main line what you must understand. Philosophical and thought-provoking poem. It will make the parents realize their responsibility in making their children happy. Philosophical, thought-provoking poem. Extracted means taken, selected from the prophet, written by Khalil Gibran, a great poet and artist. First and second, in the present poem, in this poem, the poet has conveyed, expressed, explained the philosophical through the philosophical sermon regarding the role and responsibilities. Role and responsibilities of the parents in bringing up their children. How they should take care of their children. 9 lines explain. First 5 lines will explain what are, who are the children. Next one. This is. First, let us understand. Now, this is the introduction line in the poem. Main line will be found very soon. Now, and now poem. main poem, which is shown or which is printed in your textbook. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us on children." And he said, this is the background or introduction in the poem itself. And when Al-Mustafa, he was about to catch his ship, then this lady requested Al-Mustafa, and who is holding, this lady is holding a babe, and she is saying that, "Please, O Father, speak to us on children." Please understand. O Father, please speak to us. Us means what? Total parents. Us. Not to speak to me. To me means about only my child. She is not selfish. She is unselfish. It is by speak to us, plural. On children, plural, not singular. It is by, O Father, say something about children universally and totally. This lady request. Then the father starts to explain who are called on children. This is there. I will explain now.
Start.
So, on children. Now, the prophet or Al-Mustafa starts to explain what are children, who are children, who are parents, who is God. These three things are explained. Now, I will recite, not reading the poem, recite the poem. My dear students, I will explain the poem now. After the explanation is over, we have to write the summary of the poem. How? After this explanation is over, read the textbook once or twice, understand each and every word and line. Later, write the summary in your notebook, and you must write 15 one-mark questions compulsorily. Then only you will become thorough. It is the last chance to you to adjust to this kind of teaching. Once we start entering fourth chapter, later on, there is no chance for you to adjust to this teaching. This way, you must understand these three chapters, initial three chapters thoroughly. Then only you can understand remaining chapters. Please, 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 careful. Next, I will recite the poem now. How many lines are there? 14 lines. Now, I will explain each and every line, each and every word. Now, your children are not your children. Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing, not longing. Longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. For they have their own thoughts. You may house their bodies, not their souls. For their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. Next. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, not tarries with yesterday. You are the boat from which your children are living arrows are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite and bends you with his might that his arrows may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for gladness, for even as he loves the arrow that flies, so he loves also the bow that is stable. So, this is the poem. Now, I will start explaining each and every line and each and every word. Please carefully follow the summary. Now onwards, you must have some more interest. You must read the poem and lesson textbook. You must read a lot of times indeed. If you don't work hard now,
later on it will become very difficult for you. Please, later you have to regret a lot in it if you don't follow the teaching strictly, if you don't read the textbook often and often. Read the textbook, understand this one, that then it will help you to score maximum marks in it. Please, next. Now see, when this lady who is holding a bell against her bosom requests him to speak on children, then this prophet father says, first line, your children are not your children. That means what? Oh mother, all of your parents' children are not their children. Then whose children? Some other children means all are human beings only, now. It is explained, the solution can be found in these two lines. Now, this prophet says with the opening line that your children are not your children. You means who? Parents. They means who? Children. You must remember. That means, oh parent, you don't feel that your children are your property. Your children are not your own. They are not your property like building, land or any vehicle. Why? They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They means who? Children. Children are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. Children, sons and daughters are born to enjoy their own life only, not to live like slaves in the hands of parents. Their life is their own only. They are born to take care of their life only, not for the sake of others' life. That means what? Life's longing for itself means their life. Who's that? Children's life is for themselves only, not for parents. This line is very, very tough. Please understand. Their life is for theirs only, their own only. Their life is their own. O-W-N, one only, not for others. You understand? Next. They come through you but not from you. That means parents have given birth to their children, but they have not given the life, jiva. Understand? They have given the birth to the bodies of their children, not the jiva, atma. It is why they come through you but not from you. Means children are sent from God, they have come through the parents. Parents are only a medium, a mean, a transportation vehicle, that's all. They are not the creators of their children. This is the meaning of the third line. Next. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. Even though children are living with their parents, but they do not belong to the parents. That means what? Parents may live with the children. Children may live with the parents, but they are not the properties of the parents. It is why they may live with the parents, but they do not belong to them. They cannot control. Parents cannot control their children. Why? Why should we take this line seriously? Means you may give them your love, but not your thoughts. Parents can give their love and affection to their children, but not their thoughts. This line, see, one line is answer, one line is question. One line is answer, this line itself is a question. It is why answer can become a question, question can become an answer. This is the method. It is why I have told today several times that you take the teaching seriously, otherwise marks will not become serious for you forever. Now, parents can give their children love and affection, not their thoughts. This is the answer. Why children do not belong to the parents? Yes, because parents can give their love and affection, not their thoughts. Answer. Again, this one will become question. Why should parents give their love and affection only, not their thoughts? This is the question. See, what is the answer? First, because their children have their own thoughts. Children have their own thoughts. It is why parents can give their love and affection, not their thoughts. This is the meaning. Next. You may house their bodies, not their souls. Parents can give the birth or shelter or protection to the bodies of their children. Parents can give the protection, safety to the bodies of their children, not to their souls. Souls means jiva, atma. Nobody can save the life of anybody. If a person is dead, nobody can give the life back. It is why parents can give the birth to the bodies of their children, not the soul. Why? Again, answer. For their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. Very tough line to understand. Understand now. Why can parents shelter their bodies, not their souls? Means their means children's souls, atma, jiva, dwell, remain, stay in the house of tomorrow. That means, now understand. Easily it can be understood if you can follow the teaching and if you like and understand. Now listen. Why can parents give only love, not their thoughts? Means children have their own thoughts. Next one. Why parents can give only shelter and protection to the bodies, not the souls? Means their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. Children's souls remain in the house of tomorrow. That means, simply saying, parents belong to past. Children belong to future. Once more. Parents, I belong to past tense. Our children belong to future. You can see 2060. You can live for 50 more years or 40 more years. Is there any guarantee for the parents to stay alive for more than 50 years? Not possible. It is why children belong to the future. Parents belong to the past. It is why these parents can give birth to the bodies of their children, not the souls, because souls stay in the future. Children belong to the future. Parents belong to the past. Yesterday. You belong to tomorrow. I belong to yesterday. It is the meaning of this one.